Good morning to all my lovely students. I hope you all are fine and taking good care of yourself, right? So, students, today we are going to revise both the chapters. I will tell you in which kind questions can come in your UT exam. Okay? So, I'll show you the pattern through a worksheet of combined syllabus of chapter number 1 and 2 reader and chapter number 1 and 2 of grammar also. So let's start. So this is your revision worksheet of your complete UT syllabus. So do practice accordingly, all of you. Questions will come in this type only. Your question number 1 is tick the correct option. Sentence has 4 parts, 2 parts. Tick the right answer. What is said about the subject is called sentence or predicate. Third is sentence has no sense or complete sense. Fourth is I am tired today. I is subject or sentence. Last is you are lazy. Are lazy is predicate or subject. Now we will continue with page number 2. Question number 2. Fill in the given blanks. Granny says it's dash. If you don't put your toys back, where they dash? So fill the right answer. Birbal gave all the 8 helpers a dash of dash size. Fill the right answer. Third question is true or false. Akbar caught the thief at the end. True or false? Birbal called Akbar in his court. True or false? Birbal was respected for his cleverness. True or false? Your question number 4 is complete the given words. You have to complete these words according to your difficult words or chapter of chapter number 1 reader. So do accordingly. Okay. Now we will continue with the next page. Your question number 5. Your question number 5 is what did the thief do on being caught? So write down the answer what the thief had done when he was caught. Your question number 6 is rearrange the jumbled words into meaningful sentences. Here jumbled words are given, you have to frame a proper complete sentence. Saw a beautiful eye butterfly. Make a complete sentence, proper sentence. Is friend your who? Feeling am hungry I. So frame proper sentences, okay, of both the 3 statements. Now we will continue with our next page and our next question. Now we will continue with our question number 7. Your question number 7 is write the meaning and frame sentences. Word meanings you will do. First word is robbery. Write down the meaning of robbery and then frame a sentence accordingly. Your second word is allowed. Write down the meaning of allowed and then frame a sentence. Your last question is question number 8. Match the subject with appropriate predicate. Now in this question you will not make lines, students. Nobody will make lines in this question. You will write down only numbers at the corner of column B. Okay, at the side of column B. So don't make lines in this question, cross lines. Okay, do practice and all the best to all of you for your UTs. Take care, students. Bye.